It's dark like my soul, Jason.
But, Senpai, my soul is enlightened by your presence.
All right, well... Then let's load this up and see some business here.
That's a beetle.
Yeah, that's my beetle friend. This is Let It Die.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've been playing this. That's right.
Yeah. Came out kind of out of nowhere at the PlayStation Experience. They were just like, yo, this is out today.
Oh, I like this visual treatment.
There's
here.
A lot of good... Yeah, it's a grasshopper game. It's got
some Unreal tech.
Yeah, it's got some style.
It does have some style.
Like you might expect from a grasshopper game.
That's true, yeah. I saw this at, I want to say, E3. I didn't know that it was a grasshopper joint at that juncture. But they had one of the characters there, Uncle Death.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that looks so cool. He was there cosplaying, and his stupid scythe hit me in the head.
Oh.
And I'm like, fuck this game.
Yep.
I never want to have anything to do with it.
Yeah, yeah.
And yeah, then they announced it at the PlayStation Experience. Just like, hey, it's free.
Yeah, it's out now.
Go play
this
it
thing,
now.
Yeah, I guess this has been kicking around for years under a different name for a little while.
Okay.
And yeah, it's finally out. It's neat. It's a free-to-play game.
Yep.
It's got some, you know, microtransactions and that sort of stuff going on in it, but
it's minimal. Like it's you're buying like a specific type of currency. It's not like you're buying like items or power-ups or anything like that.
You can kind of
use some of that currency for.
You can use the currency to like speed up some research and some of that stuff, like some timers basically. But it hasn't seemed too restrictive yet. But that said, I'm on the fourth level. And there are 40, I think. So it's hard to know how it will go.
That's kind of the setup here. So yeah, you're playing as a character, little meta action going on inside of like a VR game, and you're supposed to get to the top of this tower, battle your way there. In like a Dark Souls-ish kind of.
It's a rogue-like sort of thing, permadeath. But that's where the microtransactions come in, because you can kind of buy your way back into existence.
And you've got a saw blade for a weapon.
Yeah,
that's pretty.
But
cool.
Also, it's like you have multiple playable. So, I guess here's the setup. I can go back to the arcade at any time and hang out with Uncle Death.
Oh,
so
I want to play those fighting games.
Yeah. So as a result, like the individual characters in the world don't matter all that much. If you let them die, it's kind of okay.
Okay.
At least that's been my impression so far. I haven't actually had to die yet.
The whole game makes sense though.
We're gonna get a tip out of this guy's hair.
Okay. Good. Creep around. Noise.
Okay. Crouch around Cohen. Cohen is not that hard to beat.
This guy clearly knows. Is he wearing a Sylphied shirt?
Yes. Also, he's wearing a Sylphied shirt.
Oh, sweet.
Over here, she'll give you quests.
She looks pretty eager to do so.
Games? Me? I have no idea. You should ask Meijin. He's like a total big like gamer, like weird head emo, big games.
Weird head emo, big games.
Uh huh. So you know, various quests to complete can be found here.
What's the reward for those guys? Is it mostly like money or?
It varies. Sometimes it's money or sometimes it's like a food item and stuff like that.
Cool.
Then you got the radio. I've set it to the one that sounds most like a numbers station.
Oh, nice. I dug through there and there's like 200 tracks or something.
Yeah.
And they've all been pretty good. So the normal, this is like the radio station with the jingle and everything. This is great.
Yeah.
And they go through like a top 10.
This program is brought to you by Yokoyama Enterprises.
And then eventually you just get into just individual songs.
Yeah.
And so this factors into the kind of multiplayer component also, because this is the sound that plays in game when you are in your waiting room, which
cool.
We'll talk to Uncle Beth here. Medical
checkup. Turns out I don't have any internal organs. Just nasty gunky shit. Anyway,
me too,
ready
man.
To play?
Yeah, same. Okay, so now that radio station will play here. So this is your waiting room. This is where kind of everything starts. You've got a couple of shops. Here's a shop where you can buy some mushrooms, which are like healing items, food items, boosts, and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff going on in this game, and I feel like it's really hard for us to just kind of whip through an explanation.
Yeah.
You've got a shop here where this guy will sell you items and weapons and stuff like that. You find blueprints in the dungeon that you bring back here, and that makes you able to just buy them here instead of finding them.
Sweet.
You've got a bank here to store items in. You've got your daily login bonuses and quest rewards and stuff come in here.
As you do with free play games.
Yeah. And then over here is where the multiplayer type stuff happens.
And that doesn't unlock right away.
Yeah.
Thankfully.
This game kind of just, it has layers. It kind of just shows you more and more and more as you go. Here's the bathroom.
Oh, you don't have any, you haven't captured it anymore.
No, he got out. I'm playing as the guy I captured.
Oh my God.
Yeah. The freezer over here is where you store your fighters. You have multiple fighters. You can kind of switch between them at any time. And I'll go into why that might matter after we maybe run through the tower a little bit. This is where you go to level up. This little guy, I'll level you up.
That brain guy?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, I don't think I have.
It just pumps you full of strength juice and dex juice.
Yeah, okay. So, some stats. You gain XP, then you spend the XP to level up. And the... Right now, I'm only making grade 1 characters, which max out at 5 here. Grade 2 characters, I think, can go up to 10 and so on and so forth.
Gotcha.
I think, but again, I haven't unlocked that stuff for myself yet. So.
Do you know how you get up to a second grade?
I think you have to beat the first boss.
Okay.
And Cohen is not the first boss.
He's just a mid-boss. Yeah, I found that out later. Because, I've got a character right now who is maxed in all that stuff, and I'm like, I'm only on, like, the
right.
third,
yeah,
fourth
you, yeah,
floor.
You max that stuff out super easily.
Okay.
So we can just go into the level 1 of the dungeon. But as you go through the dungeon, you find elevators and activate them, and that lets you go there anytime you want.
But you gotta pay.
So you gotta pay. Or, this is where some of the free-to-play stuff happens, you can buy a 30-day pass for the express elevator, and you can ride the express elevator for free. But these coin prices are nothing. This might as well be zero.
It's pretty nominal.
So, let's just go into level 1.
Okay. Yeah, you got a nice solid chunk of cash.
I've been maxed out for most of the time, or close to it. You have to spend a different currency that is still a free-to-play currency, called Splithium, to upgrade the maximum bank size and how many fighters you can store and stuff like that.
Gotcha. These load times.
They're a little intense.
They're a little intense. Usually, as you're going from floor to floor, they'll give you like a recap, which we'll see a little bit later, I'm sure. Give you a little something to occupy yourself with.
All right, so in the Tower of Barbs, you fight, and you've got stamina, which is represented when you run here. You see his heart start to glow in his chest here. That'll start to pound more and more and more.
Have you pushed it? Have you pushed it to the limit?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you have? What happens?
I'll show you.
Okay.
That.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I thought he was going to die.
No, he doesn't.
So
just, he doesn't just blow up. For a while, I thought that'd be cool.
Yeah.
Also, if I'm running, I can do a sick drop kick.
Yes.
Which is a devastating attack and fun. There's some wrestling moves in this game.
Much like real life, yeah.
It's a grasshopper game. All right, so I use left and right on the D-pad to change out what's in my two hands here, which is pretty handy. I've got my death bag, which is your inventory.
Gotcha.
This character is like a pack rat kind of carrier class, so he's got 30 slots.
I was going to say, that looks like more
the average characters don't have that. All right, so...
So if you've got that bonus, what's the negative to the...
I assume he has worse stats, but I haven't necessarily compared the stats one-to-one to know.
Okay.
There's a lot of mushrooms in this game. You can put them in your bag, or you can just immediately eat them. Once they're in your bag, along with beasts, when you see I've got some frogs up there in my inventory.
And a rat, yeah.
And a rat, yeah. I use the touchpad to kind of scroll through it, and then I can either eat the item or throw it, so...
Why would you want to throw a frog at someone?
You wouldn't throw the frog, but there are mushrooms that'll, like, be bombs, basically, that you might want to throw.
Or, like, let off, like, a poison cloud.
Yeah.
Cool.
Also, you can cook things by throwing them into fire, and some of the things will have different effects.
Get that frog.
All right, we caught that frog. We're going to put it in our bag for later.
Decide his fate.
Yeah. If I can also stomp on them instead of picking them up, and then you get a mushroom, but that's usually not as good.
So you just ground it? Wow. He just turns into a mushroom?
When you just stomp on a beast a mushroom kind of pops out.
Circle of life.
Yeah. All right, it's momentum based combat. Kind of wind up stuff. 3-hit combos generally.
They kind of lock on.
Yeah. Okay. Oh. Yeah, I can lock on with the right stick. I've not been using the lock-on very much, and now that I'm on the fourth floor, I'm actually starting to use it more.
Same here, yeah. I didn't need it at first, but you're trying to deal with multiple enemies, that's where this game gets really, really hairy.
So I just leveled up in mastery. Oh, wait. in one of the weapons I've been using. So
holy Christ, you gain, there's lots going on.
Yeah, so you gain mastery level. My fists are level 11. Now my hammer is level 11. And you see on the right side here the bonuses you kind of get here.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
Of like, oh, now I have a different move that I can do. Normally it's the twos that do the attack, L2, R2. Uh-huh. But you unlock skill moves that you perform with ones.
I didn't know that. Yeah. Okay, awesome.
And so I've got that for the hammer now. And that can be pretty useful.
That looks like a sideswipe, like AoE.
Yeah, it's you know, a wider AoE, hit that'll, you know, if you got two guys in front of you, it'll kind of knock them back a little bit. Let's see. Also, I gained enough XP to level up. So I could just run back down and run back down to the waiting room and spend that point. But, you know, we're just going to, we can definitely make it through level one here.
I don't want to sit through that load again.
Yeah. Oh, also, let's see. That mosquito thing at the bottom is a decal. You equip decals under your character, you see right there.
Oh, of course.
That one gives me 3% of my damage back as life.
Oh, that's, yeah, super helpful. I've got that one, too.
Yeah. Also, you can block and roll.
Okay. When you block, does it still take health?
Normally, yes. If you perfect block, if you kind of time it right,
really?
If you just defend... It will cause them to bounce off.
Oh,
you
shit.
Take zero damage, they get stunned and are wide open for counters.
I missed that somehow.
Yeah. It's all in here,
yeah.
But yeah, it's, you know, you're kind of going through, this is the tips that you get from that fighting game player in the arcade.
He is sharing some knowledge.
That's this great. Is stuff that you get when you spend currency on things. Mm-hmm. Uncle Death has all kinds of tips for you. And then Captain Yotsuyama has separate kind of game-wide things about maintenance and login bonuses and stuff like that.
Okay.
And then if we go over here, you've got the quests I've accepted and cleared. And then over here, you've got the Beast Encyclopedia, the Book of Decals that tells you the ones you've seen and what they do, what the mushrooms do when you cook them. And then you've got some collectibles like Tales from the Barbs and this catalog thing, the stamp rally. Every floor, there's a stamp machine.
Yeah.
I have not found the one on the third floor yet. Or the fourth floor, for that matter. And then in here, you've got Barb's Bible, which is the actual, like,
tutorial
stuff. Yeah. It surfaces the stuff as you find it, but also you can revisit it. And you'll need to. I've had to revisit this one to go, like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Dexterity, that seems like that'd be good. Oh, wait, it's just for firearm attacks. That's super lame. Fuck mm-hmm. Dexterity. But also, like, you level up so easily, it's not. You might as well get full dex while you're at it.
Yeah, I suppose.
Haters. We'll probably see some haters.
As we come across a hater, let's talk about that.
Yeah. Ooh, jungle machete.
Holy shit.
I haven't seen one of these before.
Neither have I.
Sweet, we're totally picking up this jungle machete.
Weapons that you find in here might seem kind of cool, but the durability is usually pretty low.
Yeah, but you also find, so you find blueprints in here, and you bring those back to the waiting room, and then bring them to the shopkeeper, and then you'll be able to make full durability versions of those weapons. Fuck yeah, this machete's awesome.
Oh shit, yeah.
And getting kills with a weapon is what helps you gain mastery in it. So
okay.
I kind of want to use this machete, because now, yes, you already attack power plus one. For going up a level in it. Of course, as I use it, it's, you know, I'm burning it up.
How's this interface been treating you?
It's okay. It's been all right. It's not perfect.
It takes some getting used to for sure.
Oh, shit.
But once you've got it down, I think, the ability to just like, okay, I want to eat this or equip it or store it or equip it in one of my hands. Oh, here we go.
That's a gortastic kill. And Uncle Death comes out to let you know that he is pleased. When you perform those, like, you kind of knock him into a stun state, and then you get to kill him. And those kills are different depending on what weapon you have equipped. See, I already burned that jungle machete. It's already gone.
Oh, man. Yep. Frog in the pocket.
All right, that's the stair... Oh, is this just the staircase that just goes
this
up?
This is still part of the level.
Yeah, so that's... I opened up a shortcut to floor 2 after beating the first sub-boss. That way opens up, but that's no fun. We're here to kill things.
Yeah.
And level up, you know?
Your name's Abby.
That's all random, yeah.
Oh. Ouch. Nice. There's some satisfying stuff going on with the combat. Like some of the hits like really feel like they're carrying weight.
There's some pretty brutal stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like the kill that you do when you're just barehanded is like you put them in the torture rack until they blow up.
Yeah.
Oh, see if I... Oh, that guy's got an iron. Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
There's a hater.
This is bad. This is real bad.
All right, the hater also will attack other enemies, which is kind of handy.
The hater just hates.
And so the hater is the, you know, the ghost of another player. So you have multiple fighters in the game.
Right.
Like I said, they're in the freezer. You can take your spare fighters and send them out into other people's games.
Okay.
Also, if you die in the tower, your character will become a hater on the floor that you died on.
So if you came back to that location with your new character, you'd have to fight your old self?
Yeah. I blew that dude up.
So you get like some of the stuff that you dropped?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
They have you to kind of die almost deliberately as part of the tutorial, it seems like. And
look at that coat.
All right, well, we're going to pick that up, but I'm not going to put it on because I don't know that it's better than what I'm wearing.
You should probably eat that frog.
Yeah, we're going to eat this frog. All right. And then pick this box. The haters kind of pop up as you go.
Okay.
And that's a result of, like, that guy's on my friends list, and he probably sent his fighter deliberately into my game.
What a dick.
I know. Fuck that guy.
Hey, there's another frog.
Nattle.
In your pocket you go.
So, by default, the frog restores a small amount of health, but if you cook them by throwing them into a fire, then they do medium.
Oh, okay.
Which is nice. I'll get this red hot iron just to show it, because it's kind of a silly weapon. But it's maybe not my favorite. Let's go with a hammer on the other hand.
Good choice.
Let's see if I can sneak up on a guy, because you can just fucking... I don't know if these guys can be snuck up on.
That just releases like a steam cloud?
Yeah.
And they... Oh, yeah. Ever been burned by an iron?
Yeah.
Sucks. Bad. Oh.
And Uncle Death talks out of the controller speaker, which is why you're not hearing him go, sweet, when I get those kills. All right,
this is hairy.
Okay, these they're fireworks launchers just fire. Suck.
Yeah.
They're just terrible weapons. You can get them off these guys, but seriously.
I just sell them.
Oops, I accidentally used a rage attack there because he was stunned and I was trying to do the gore-tastic kill. Oh, see, it did it again, but I was already knocking off my third hit.
I see that zero up there, and there's a meter going up.
Yeah, that's the rage meter. Gotcha. So it's like if I hold down triangle and hit one of my attack buttons, you hit real hard.
Once you get it stuck, yeah. Ooh.
Okay, so what do we got? We got an attack coat here, and we'll pick that up.
Yeah.
Is this a hammer here? All right, hammers. I'm a hammer fan. I'm a hammer man. I like to keep at least one fist open because, or at least, you know, because you can equip six things, but I like to have at least one slot be empty because sometimes you just need a fist to get in there quickly.
Okay, gotcha.
And interrupt some attacks. So unarmed is actually pretty useful.
Especially once you get leveled up.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, you know, my fists are like level 11 or something, so.
Mine too.
I mean, no, I can tell, but looking at it, it's just, it's crazy over there.
That looks like a special box. Dr. Drill Mask?
All right, I got a drill mask here. And because there's durability on all these items and you can't really repair durability, like you need those things,
that's
you know?
True.
My clothes are gonna blow up.
Have the environments changed up for you very much? Or?
Not too much.
Not too much.
All right, so here's a heart shroom that restores medium. That's very useful.
Nice. I got two now.
And those things don't stack, like your inventory. The inventory situation in this game is a hassle, honestly. It's you know, it's the thing that prevents you from just like continuing to always go forward is like, oh, I got all these blueprints and my inventory's full and I don't want to die and lose the blueprints and we need to go back.
Yeah.
And as soon as you leave a floor, it repopulates. So you can't, you know, you can't always just turn around and go back. So the first time you get here, you got to pull this to activate the elevator. And
people
then,
on you? I hear people.
Oh, hey, hi.
Yeah.
And now that this elevator's been active, I can take it to a higher floor, or I can, you know, just unlock it so I can return here later if I need to. So this means that I could go back to the waiting room, cash in all our stuff, manage my inventory, and then come right back here. This floor will repopulate, but it doesn't matter because it's at the end of the floor anyway.
I wonder how that continues throughout. That seems like a good thing. right? Like,
yeah.
To have the escalator right at the end there, by the elevators?
You'd either want it there, or you'd want the elevator right at the beginning of a level, you know? So yeah, here's what you were talking about, where we get to see this kind of path. There I was running around in circles, and then
great.
We ran over here, did this fight, killed this guy.
Yeah, I remember that.
Picked up this frog.
Yep. Then you change weapons.
Uh-huh.
I love how it'll change the inventory.
Yeah.
It's a neat idea. I mean, something's gotta happen during this load screen.
Yeah. It's already done loading, we can move on, but
that's true.
You know, just...
materials. Awesome.
So I'm not sure what the rules are for what floors have elevators. It looks like the second floor does not have one.
Okay.
But the third and fourth do. And might just be because the fourth is where a boss fight is, a mid-boss. So they put an elevator there, but...
That makes sense.
But I'm not positive. All right.
I think you should get that guy's hat. If you're lucky. Oh.
Yeah. There you go.
There we go.
Uncle Death was impressed by my ability to break that thing in half.
He's like, I've seen Nikki Bella do a rack attack.
Mm-hmm.
And it was not as impressive.
No, definitely not.
Oh.
Let's see if I can do it.
Creep.
See if I can do it. Ah!
Damn it.
Shit.
I think I've only gotten that to work if I'm like above them or something.
Mm.
Oh, man, you get that happening pretty often.
Yeah, this is the most it's ever happened, honestly.
Really?
Okay, combat pickaxe is a two-handed weapon. I'm just not even going to take it.
Okay.
We got some rats up here.
What do the rats go for?
The rats are medium health, whether you cook them or not.
Sweet.
They're always...
Oh, that little
you
son
fucker.
Of a bitch scampers away. It's delicious.
Okay, so...
There might be some goodies up there. Oh, yeah. There's some goodies.
Yeah. Okay, so these are materials you use to craft the blueprints when you bring them back.
Gotcha.
And then you can once you've unlocked a blueprint,
you can just spend money to make
them. No, it's not. Yeah, you spend money to make them, but also if you find the materials again, you can level up your blueprints.
Oh, that's
so it starts making like plus one bats and plus two this and that. I don't know he dropped anything. Did he have anything? My inventory's totally full, so.
Man, we should have went back.
Yeah.
What if we find a blueprint? Oh, get rid of it.
Then I'll just start dropping frogs or weapons or whatever. Like, I've picked up a lot of hats and shit, so.
Right.
This room is sometimes really intense. So these levels change slightly.
Oh, they're fighting
But they're kind
one
of
another.
Prefab parts. If they're fighting each other, that means there's a hater over there.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Yep.
We gotta go.
Yep.
Let's see if we can draw them out slowly.
All right. Try that R1 attack. If they're bunched up.
Oh!
Oh, man.
Use my rage attack there just to knock that one down more. Oh, shit. All right. We're okay. This is fine.
Oh, yeah. Hat's almost dead.
Okay.
That hater just got a stupid firework gun.
Yeah, that's a weird thing
to
have
hammer
equipped.
Too.
But, okay. And then ran out of ammo.
Ooh.
And then ran out of everything else. All right, my hammer leveled up.
Plus five.
And there's another hammer here, which we've been burning through hammers, so maybe I should pick up a hammer. As much as actually the right answer is to pick up this cotton. Shit, the right answer is definitely to pick up this cotton.
It is.
All right, well, I took some damage. Let's just eat a frog.
Yeah, just a frog, not a rat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wait, was that a good frog?
I don't know.
Oh, man. I think I had a golden frog that is a full life restore, and I just ate that instead of my weak frogs.
Just reload your save.
That's not. If we quit right now, it's as good as this character dying. And so at launch, that was actually a problem. People were losing characters because the servers were like going down while they were playing. Mm-hmm. And they're like, oh, you quit while you were not in the waiting room. So guess what? Your fighter's dead. And that sucks. They were like, there's like, if you go back through these Captain Yotsuyama messages.
They kind of make good.
Apology medal.
Yep.
10,000 kill coins, one death medal, which death medal is the premium currency. And then apology medal two for server connection issues. Apology medal, apology medal. So, you know, they've been trying to make good. Actually, the stuff they gave you is actually way better than whatever low level fighters people would have had on launch day. So. And we got some splithium over here.
Yeah.
All right.
Some materials. I mean,
it's
probably.
Okay, let's equip the. What's our hat looking like here? It's five.
Hat's in rough shape.
So we're gonna just trash it.
Okay.
And then we're gonna.
Do you have another hat to put on?
I've got a lot of hats. We're gonna put on this hat.
Yep.
And then. We're gonna. This is equipped plus 122. Okay, we don't have any other.
Yeah, you need two slots here, right?
Yeah. Okay, so we're gonna just drop some more of that.
Okay.
I'm gonna drop these buzzsaw knuckles.
Fuck them.
Keep the rat. There was boom shroom. You know, that's. I don't really ever use them. It's just not that useful. So I'm gonna get rid of that.
Seems like a lot of damage, though. I haven't used one.
22 out of 43. What kind of?
What happens if you eat a boom shroom?
I don't know.
Oh.
I've been too afraid to find out.
Yeah.
Actually, it might say in the. It might say.
Arsenal close. Okay. Boom shroom effect.
Raw explosion attack 240.
Hmm.
Okay. So I think it will kill you, or I think it will do a lot of damage, and then if you cook it, it does even more.
Okay. You've got more than 240 hit points, don't you?
Yeah.
That would be a really good way to clear out your inventory space. You eat a boom shroom and then eat a bunch of frogs.
I'm just
gonna. Do you like this logic here?
I see where you're going with that, but I'm gonna get this oil and probably move on.
Okay. Seems really, really similar to the levels that I've had too. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, the level design is like it's prefab pieces that kind of get put together in a couple of different ways, but it's not.
Okay.
Like the levels are not dramatically different.
Jeff?
Your level two probably looks a lot like my level two.
I want you to drop kick one of those guys.
Okay.
So you gotta run? You need a running start?
Oh! That's pretty awesome.
That does some damage. Oh, hi. I'm glad these guys are here, because they're easy.
Yeah, they're just easy murder, scratch metal.
Oh, man.
You know, just in the interest of us recording this video, I'm going to
Oh, man, you are going to regret
it. No, I know. Yeah, you're right.
Drop that hammer. Throw that. Yeah. You're a rat somewhere.
Oh, where did that? I cooked that frog, but where did it go?
You overcooked it. Nothing left.
All right, so now you see we picked this thing up.
Oh, okay.
And it's cooked.
So I had the very same thing happen to me. I threw something in a fire and it like disappeared, and I'm like, okay, I don't understand this cooking mechanic. Awesome.
Yeah, so that's a grilled tough shroom that now lasts longer. With its defense bonus.
Sweet.
Than it would if it was just raw. It's a silly mechanic in a game full of silly mechanics.
Yep. It's smart. I like it.
Yeah.
Whoa. Oh no.
Once you've been through these levels a couple of times, you know that there's a guy right there. There's, you know, you kind of just eventually just get a feel for it. Heavy hitter pants.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna try to just eat this rat here.
Pretty good.
I already have that blueprint, yep. So that's, you know, that's worth some money.
Oh, sure.
But
they really chase you down, don't they?
Yeah, when they spot you, they come get you, you know.
Those are really good frog noises.
Yeah. More cotton.
Oh, yeah.
I've got a little bit of room here because we've busted up some weapons and some other stuff since. So. All right. Well, so here are our options. We can go to floor three, try to work our way through floor three and get to the elevator again because I'm not going to go all the way up to floor four.
Right.
Or I can run all the way back through this floor and take the level one back down to level one and take that elevator back. We go forward? You're pointing forward.
Yeah, let's move on.
Okay. This is where it starts to get a little bit more dangerous.
On floor three?
Yeah. Or actually, I should say, so you see here, as you look at the elevator here, you'll see like, oh, okay, there's, I think that means there's an elevator there and a stamp machine.
Oh, gotcha.
Okay. Is what I think that thing on the right is. I have not found the stamp machine on this floor yet because I have not spent much time on floor three. I went through it once, got to floor four, and got to the elevator on floor four, and then went back down, and I've yet to vent. That's when the multiplayer raid stuff opened up, so I've yet to be up there again since. All right.
Oh, these guys suck.
These hovering guys are actually, yeah, they're kind of a pain in the ass.
So I've unlocked a crossbow.
Oh, okay.
That I use a lot.
Yeah, that seems like it'd be. This seems like a good spot for a ranged weapon with these guys.
Also, just one dropkick will kill these guys.
Really?
Yep. Dunzo.
And then we fell through the floor. We can just get right back up over here. Oh, here's another one of these fuckers. All right, hang on. Oh!
Yep. Ouch. Oh, that wasn't that bad. Oh no!
Shit.
That's when it gets dicey. Going hand to hand with him. Oh, hi.
What's up, man?
Sweet, okay.
Yeah. So if you just time your blocks well, then you don't really take damage, and they clash, they bounce off. Okay, so is this where... Okay, this is where I came back up. This is... Okay.
Well, that's where you came from. That's where you fell.
Right, through. Okay, this is where I came from. I just want to... There's a case over here.
Gotcha. You got some rage buildup too.
Yeah. Usually save rage for when I'm surrounded and fucked. And it's like, okay, I need to like kill my way out of this situation right now. Gonna level up my pants so much.
Mm-hmm.
Where's the stamp machine?
Whoa.
Hee hee.
I don't have this in my level three. This,
oh, really?
Yep.
What the fuck?
Oh, no. Yeah, this little moat area. Very new to me.
No, hammers are good. I've got my hammer. Oh, this is okay. Yeah, so this is a different layout than it was last time I was here.
Okay. Whoa.
Oh, there's something here this time.
Oh, silk?
Okay. Never seen silk before.
Fancy pants.
I should probably get it. Gonna make the fanciest pants. Most of these standard enemies, like, you know, your fists are pretty fast. You can kind of just plow through them. And abuse them a little bit. Was this the... Okay, this...
Nope, turn around.
Nope, okay. All right. Oop. Ah,
awesome. Corner.
Yeah, so that's the other way up if you end up kind of taking that moat area. And then we can kind of get up here to this area. There's a chest up there.
Yeah, this is a much different layout. That's good for now. Oh no! Probably come around, yeah.
That's the R1 punch. This wind-up punch is really pretty devastating.
It looks like it.
I am going to... Sorry, I was just going to plow forward, but now I'm like, I need... Oh, jeez.
Oh.
And then I did that and took some actual real damage. Yeah, that sucks.
You got frogs. You're good.
Yeah. Also, unless you're hungry, you will slowly recharge health.
Or bonus two?
Yeah.
Oh, hello.
All this wool, y'all. Let's go unarmed for a little bit here. Since I'm in a weird inventory spot.
Some shit went down in here.
Nah, it's fine. I'm more worried about the noise up here, honestly.
Oh, that... Did it see you?
Yeah, I think so.
Damn.
No.
Should drop down on stealth gun.
Oh.
Ow. Get your fucking fireworks out of here.
Yeah, these guys just... Up close, they have nothing. Oh, darn it. Could have done a cooler kill. Hey. Alright. Okay, so that probably leads back around to where that other guy was.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just go over here. There's a fire here if you want to cook something. Oh, hi. Oh, right. That's right. They always combo with the buzzsaw. I forget that every time.
How's the other roll been?
It's been alright.
I haven't noticed any, like, invincible frames during it, though.
Yeah.
Yes. Attack. Oh yeah. You're welcome.
Okay. We need to put a new hat on because, as you see, mine blew up.
Yep. I can hear that.
Let's put this one on.
Ooh, cool. A bloody Valentine.
Ooh.
Oh.
Now we have to make it back.
Yep.
Oh. Oh, wait. Okay, here's the elevator.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, cool.
Sweet.
Oh,
okay. Boom shroom. Boom shroom.
I'm not confident enough in my boom shroom abilities to,
look at
to
that.
Do it.
Look at that. He's so vulnerable after that. It's 240 damage. Oh, see? Okay.
Yeah,
that's lucked out.
Yeah, I mean, he had me. Okay.
I've noticed if you get surrounded, like if you get cornered by a couple enemies, they can put you into a stun lock, and it's
It's hard. It's rough. It's those rage moves can you can sometimes punch through that, and get out of it that way. I've saved myself with those before, but your health can just. Disappear in this game,
which adds to some tension for sure.
Because like you're like surrounded, you're taking hits. Time. Like if you have all these like low durability items, like you might just find yourself armorless almost immediately, and then you're just done in some situations.
He has some pants.
Yeah.
So when you're making a new character, you can choose like a loadout or class.
You choose a
thing?
Class, yeah. Okay. And so there are some different choices you can make there. Like all arounder is kind of the standard one, but this one is the, you know, I don't know what it's called. We can look, but this is the one that just has more item, like more inventory slots.
Gotcha. I didn't know they had one of those. That's cool.
The idea being this would be a character you would have to make runs to pick up blueprints, but maybe you'd have another character that you'd use to fight bosses.
Yep.
Because it would do more damage or whatever the actual trade-off is.
You're ascending into the brain.
Yeah. You're right, I do need pants. I didn't realize my pants had blown up until just now.
I've been keeping a close eye on
that. Yeah. All right, so we'll get some strength and some vitality. And a little bit of luck here.
Do you know if you can Like if the experience stays on you, like if you just put a few points in him, throw him in the freezer.
I think it's per character.
Per character, okay. Yeah.
46.49 okay,
this
so.
That's a good tune.
Yeah. All right. I'll see what this blueprint is.
Yes!
All right,
yes.
The traffic cone head.
It's turned out well.
Oh, shit. You can make a fucking, baseball.
Yeah, so these are all the blueprints I have, and I've got, since I picked up all that cotton, I can now level up my pants.
Cool.
Nothing goes wrong under my watch.
And then that takes, you know, 3 minutes or whatever to complete. Let's level up the what Dark Ryback body.
Uh-huh.
Dark Ryback, way more evil than regular Ryback.
It's more stiff, yeah.
Yeah. Let's go to +3 on my DIY attack coat. So you see the equip requirements change on this stuff. So now I'll need 208 hit points to equip the new attack coat.
That doesn't seem like much.
But you start with 200. So right. this now means that like at level one, a fresh character can't actually buy any of this
until
stuff.
Until you level them up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's take a look.
Let's use my iron scraps to level up this hammer.
Let's take a look.
And okay, what's the, 12 durability. Like this is not gonna be better than
But what are the stats on it though?
Okay, what are we, yes.
Like it could give you
It's been hard bonuses. To read some of the stats on this armor because I'm kind of thinking like, okay, well what does all this stuff actually do?
So plus the hit points.
Mm-hmm. Minus to
speed, strength, nothing.
I don't know what that 5% is there.
Dexterity? I don't know, that's like a hand
type
thing.
Yeah. Well, let's level it up anyway because we got waste oil.
Plus 5% gang signs.
I mean, I could level up this fireworks launcher, but
nope.
Like, I don't
do
who
it.
Who cares?
Don't do it.
Yeah.
What's the one to the right there? I've got the same thing.
Flame wand.
Jesus Christ, required HP 650?
Yeah, like I got the blueprint out of the Uncle Prime box over here.
Yeah, yeah.
You can open every 20 hours.
Daily login bonus type thing?
Sort of, yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't know. Do I have any pants? I don't, do I?
Really?
I mean, I could make some pants. Yeah, it's not, probably not that hard.
Oh, welcome back.
Yep.
Thanks.
So there's a counter on that, too.
Yeah, you can't just sit there and buy pants forever. I don't know why there's a counter on that. That seems like a weird thing to do, but...
I mean, you should just be free to buy pants whenever
That's
you
what
want.
I think. All right, let's store some stuff, like this wool
mm-hmm.
and this silk.
And you don't have to have that stuff on you
right.
when you go
yeah.
to
like, Yeah, you don't have to pull it out of the store cool. to then use it to build, which is good. Let's attack mushroom, put it in there. Let's store one of these away. We're probably going to need it immediately.
You still got your fancy frog?
I think I found another one.
Oh, gotcha.
I'm not sure. You know, so I can take my fighters from the freezer here, which I don't know that they'll actually be in here because I think they're all on defense. Oh, no, I got one in here. Okay.
A couple of
defense. Oh, no, deployed. Okay, deployed is defense. So, yeah, I've got my two fighters here, both deployed in defense of my base. Whoa. And so, yeah, I can also deploy them into other people's games, but right now they're deployed defending my bank from attack.
Gotcha.
And if you have them equipped with items you buy from the store, those items don't degrade when they are attacked.
Oh, cool.
If you equip them with stuff you found in the dungeon, that stuff can and definitely will break.
Oh, I see.
Okay, so this is the other part of the game that unlocked.
Tokyo Death Metro.
My friend Tetsuo here.
What's up?
On the Tokyo Death Metro. You choose a team. I'm on Team California.
And I really like the stylized like logos yeah. for all the states. That's yeah. rad.
Got Canada up here.
Uh-huh.
And so they set up wars between the teams where like California has been at war with the UK and stuff like that, where it seems like they kind of balance it up. So you're kind of encouraged, I think it encourages you to raid people that are in a certain territory.
Okay.
And this is not live multiplayer. This is
you're gonna be fighting
asynchronous.
Against,
we're
AI.
Fighting this AI, yeah. So, okay, I don't have enough splithium to upgrade my freezer, my bank, my tank, and my restroom.
Walk me through this shit.
Okay.
There's a lot going on here.
So you see up there in the upper right where the maximum kill coins I can have is 70,000. The one below that at the bottom is splithium. That's also 70,000. Splithium is the currency I use for these upgrades.
Okay.
Those are the two currencies that can be raided when we go raid someone else.
Gotcha.
So that seems like that's the fast way to get these things. I was full of both of these for a while, and then I got raided, and now here
jacked.
We are. The restroom, so you can capture fighters.
Yep.
Sometimes I think when you kill a hater, you might be able to capture them there.
Okay.
But also you can capture them on raids. When you catch them on a raid and bring them back, they need to be deprogrammed, so they're in your restroom for, in the first case, 48 hours.
That's
for the first fighter.
Go to deprogram.
So you, this will let you have more for deprogramming going at the same time.
Oh, cool. Okay.
If you have a bigger, like more restroom slots. And then the freezer is just how many fighters you can have at a given time.
Sweet. Okay. Got that. 2 average level. Yeah, a lot of stats going on. Okay.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I think I get it.
Okay. So we don't have enough to buy anything, which is a bummer.
Well, we should go get some.
Because we're susceptible. Yeah, we should probably go get some. Defense settings. I've got my two fighters here in the platform room, which is where you first spawn. The bases are not super substantial. I'm not buying defenses. I'm just deploying fighters. I'm not like, oh, let's put a gun turret in here or anything like that. It's not that elaborate.
Lay down a spike trap. Whoa, boy.
Okay.
So these are all people.
Yeah, these are all people. And we can kind of see how much stuff they have for us to steal.
What happens if you tab over? So R1, L1.
Revenge.
Oh, so these are people that have jacked you.
Yeah. Well, let's go get revenge on this guy, because he's got a decent amount of splithium.
Also, he's from Alabama.
All right, Alabama. Let's do this. So I think if I die here, I don't necessarily lose the fighter. I think you just lose the fight.
Oh, this is great.
Off we go!
And I forgot, could you actually choose people? Could you do like a search for... Like,
I don't know if there was a search, okay. But you know, there's a friends leaderboard, so you can attack your friends from there.
Awesome. Okay. This is something that I was not... anticipating this layer,
yeah.
Especially to this degree.
It unlocks in a surprising way. Like, you see,
yeah.
Like, TDM rules in the thing, but it's empty. So you're like, okay, right. There's some multiplayer here, but I don't know. All right, is there a guy? Is there a guy?
All right, so you got a timer here?
Yeah, so we only have 3 minutes to get what we're going to get.
Oh,
okay,
shit.
There's no one here.
Okay,
if
good.
He's got any people, they're all up here in the waiting room itself.
What's our goal? What are we going to go for first?
We're going to smash the splithium bank,
splithium
which is right
bank.
Here.
Right. Yeah, straight ahead.
Maybe this guy has no one on defense.
That dumbass.
All right, then I'm not going to waste my weapon. I'm just going to L1 this splithium tank and take it all.
Awesome.
That's mine now.
Okay.
And then we got this bank over here.
Okay.
So
he had like 1,500 or something like that?
Yeah.
I thought I saw? Okay,
yeah.
So you got all of it. It's not in a different location?
No.
Oh. Yeah, I don't hear anyone, Jeff. It's like over 2 minutes.
All right, that might be it. Unless he's got a fighter in the bathroom. Okay, no, no.
Well, it fades out and you're done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold the colon.
That's right.
That's pretty good.
All right, so we might have enough. So it seems like what you want to do is spend everything before you log out, as much as you can,
right.
Because that'll prevent it from getting stolen from you.
Gotcha.
While you're logged out.
Makes sense.
So it's like, I don't know, like the MGS5 based stuff was a cool concept
sure.
That I felt like wasn't actually fun to play.
Yep.
This being this 3 minute thing that is just two rooms full
yeah.
of fighters, it's very snappy. You just kind of bang, bang, get in there, do your dirty business, get out.
I'm warming
and
up to it.
I think it's all right.
Okay.
Maybe we raid one more guy, see if we can find someone who actually has fighters in there.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to steal a fighter.
Yep.
Because it's that same animation or that same screen we just saw of your character sitting on the train.
Uh-huh.
But then there's just a like fighter tied up on the floor and you're sitting there arms crossed all satisfied. Let's see if that was enough currency to actually get an upgrade here.
Kind of like 8,000 now, I think.
Waiting room, buy equipment. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know that I'm going to be full anytime soon here, but
okay. Having
more fighters seems like it would always be useful. So let's just go that way. And so that's going to take 6 hours. So this is where I could spend two death medals to complete it immediately. Anything with a timer, you can hit it on and spend death medals, which that's the premium currency.
Gotcha.
It costs death medals to revive a character if you so choose, and you don't have to. Right. You can start over from level one, you know, like the leveling curve is fast, and the thing that matters is like what blueprints you have. So the only reason I could ever see reviving is if I had really good blueprints.
Okay.
That I like really wanted to get back.
Oh, totally.
Or I had a lot of stuff that I wanted to have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, especially if you can't go back to that.
Yeah, like letting the fighters die seems like totally the right move, unless you're like, oh, I'm in the middle of a boss fight and I'm really close to winning, or whatever the situation is. I'm not too clear on that. Also, there's this DH service where you can convert your death medals into kill coins if you need it. You can expand your storage with kill coins.
Your on-character storage or just your bank?
The bank.
Gotcha.
And so there also are these 30-day passes, like I said, for the elevator, and there's some benefits along those lines. I have 2 1-day passes. I have not used these yet, and I don't know how you buy those.
Yeah, I'm not sure how.
Because if we go to the store here, it just lets you buy death medals.
Uh huh.
Maybe it only comes up the first time you die. Yeah. Maybe it's like, hey, do you want to buy a pass? You know, hey, best value.
I think they give you the first one free.
They do, and I went through that one. So okay. I'm wondering if like now the second time they're like, hey, it's not free anymore. Because I don't see any way for me to go, yes, I want to use a 30-day express pass. I have these 1-day passes that I got, you know, for just playing. Yeah, and you can set it to auto renew if you so desire, and it'll just burn through your things whether you're playing or not, which seems like a bad way to go. Why don't we run one more raid?
Let's do it. Once we come back, though, I want to talk to that mushroom lady because she's something special.
Oh yeah, she's a little weird. Rescue. I don't know what rescue is. Maybe that means I can definitely. Oh, some of these characters are high rank. Here's a low rank one.
Wanna do it?
I don't know what rescue means. We should find out.
Yeah. Okay.
Rank 2. Oh, another player has attacked.
Oh.
Huh. Rank 4 with a decent amount of stuff.
Okay.
I wonder. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what rescue means.
I'm sure it's in your scrapbook.
Yeah.
Right. So it costs money to go on these raids.
Yeah. See the raid cost, but that's like.
Yeah, that's pretty.
That's not a lot. Rank 17. I don't know. I don't want
to. 7.
7 might be a little too high.
Two.
So this guy was 2. This is the guy we tried before and it
okay.
failed. So.
Refresh.
Is there a refresh?
I don't see a refresh.
No. All right. Well, who else can we take revenge on here? That's a decent amount.
Yeah.
Let's get our revenge. Our sweet revenge.
Going to Brazil.
Hold on to
something.
Got
it.
To get
actually, skip that. I like Tetsuo. He seems cool.
I like Uncle Death.
Yep, Uncle Death is good.
Got a lot of him in the beginning, but like
yeah.
throughout the game, you don't really get
not as much Uncle Death as I would have liked.
So as you go up the tower, you actually fight the named bosses.
Yep.
As well, with like intros okay. and stuff. There seems to be some really, really, really good grasshopper stuff, goofiness going on.
Yeah. All right. What do we got?
Hell's that way. Anyone?
Nothing.
Anyone?
Huh. Free money.
Damn it. Okay.
And so you hear their radio choice playing in their waiting room.
So if you tried to, I don't have any defenses set up. You could jack my stuff, Jeff.
Yeah, I could.
Oh damn! Don't do that. I gotta go home and set up my defenses.
But you know, it's the same AI you fight in the tower, so it's not hard. Like that's, you know, I've gotten into places that had like 2 like level 20-ish characters in it, and I just killed
enough
them.
Patience.
It's not that rough.
Yeah, that realizing that was kind of a turnoff at first, but I think if you just throw enough people out there,
yeah,
it might be a better than just like in the 2 high level characters.
And you know, there's also the gear matters too. So you know, if you've got high level characters with a lot of cool stuff on them, they're probably gonna get a couple of hits in and wear a player down. Plus, you only have 3 minutes, so a player that's hard to kill is still gonna be
sure.
enough to cause problems.
Yeah, the asynchronous nature of it. I'm just like, I don't want people coming into my stuff when I'm not around. But you raise a good point. Like, spend as much of it as you can.
Yeah, it just seems like it's like this core part of the game, and I do think it's kind of cool, even if it is a little weird, to just have your stuff.
Hey, lady.
I have not logged back in and come back to find zero. So okay. It seems like maybe it's not as terrible as it could be. Yeah. So this is where you buy the decals. And you know these kind of fall along different lines, like reduce falling damage, or if you have items that have a luck requirement to be equipped, you can reduce the requirement. This means if you equip same faction armor in all of your slots, you get a 20% defense bonus,
yep.
And you know 7% attack bonus.
This is all over the place. Wow.
Decreases damage when you're on fire. You know, I would think there'd be more. There are more, obviously, more than these.
Mm-hmm.
And so the mushroom stew, let's see, I have 35 now. I wonder if I have enough in my daily login stuff to actually buy another mushroom stew. I would like to.
Need 50,000?
50,
for
yeah.
Okay.
Nope.
And you couldn't sell enough.
Hey, no, I couldn't.
Sell some of your death metals.
No.
Hell.
No, I don't want to spend real... I'm going to go as long as I can without spending real money. But I like this game enough that I would feel okay about spending a little bit of real money in this game.
Quite a bit of enjoyment out of
yeah.
it. And I wouldn't mind it.
I like its style. I think it feels interesting.
It definitely came out of nowhere for me. What's the Mother Barb stuff?
Oh, that's some movies you can watch.
Yeah, sure, I can talk now. I can beat this guy with my eyes closed.
Oh, jeez.
Here, I'll give you a tip.
Orange names.
Bad news, man.
Smarter and faster than screamers. Since haters will attack anyone, bringing a screamer and a hater together will let you profit from their fight.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah, we know.
We're aware of that.
Yeah.
Silky shirt.
Thanks, guy.
Yeah, so over here there are some...
And you can get a real good look at the concrete jack.
Yeah.
Jackals?
Concrete Jackals is a great name for a fighting game.
Yep. That looks pretty great. I want to play it. Mother Barbs. I took a cursory glance over the IMDb page for the voice actors, and it's all over the place as well. Like Mark Hamill is like the narrator and stuff. They've got like Billy Dee Williams and
Vern Troyer.
Yeah,
Tracy Lords
is just the voice of a player character.
Yeah,
not even
so
like
just some
person.
Of those. You know, it's yeah, it's a weird voice cast. This is a weird game.
Yep.
Every day. I don't know. It's gotten me pretty excited. I definitely want to spend some more time with it.
Yeah, I wonder how the free-to-play stuff, you know, holds up over time.
Yeah,
but even
yeah.
so, like, at the outset here, however, it seems pretty great. You can call on her
expertise. Yeah, I think it's definitely worth at least giving a look, even for people who normally see free-to-play and kind of roll their eyes or something. I think there's definitely something to this. Anyway, that's this game. It's complicated and weird, and there's a lot of reading as you kind
of
onboard and get through what
layers,
this game
man.
Is, because there are a lot of layers. But so far, it seems pretty cool.
I can't wait to see you have
and there's
a
Uncle Death.
Next time.
And his glasses. He puts on different glasses all the
He's
time.
Wrench, but dead. He's Wrench from Watch Dogs 2, but dead.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. Well, that's going to do it. Thanks, Jason.
Thank you.